Good morning and welcome. The priest in session for this morning's Mass is Bill Rathkin by Bud and Karen. If you would please now take a moment to silence your cell phones. Thank you.
Good morning, and welcome. We sign ourselves in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And may our Lord be with all of you.
Amen.
And we come before the Lord this morning, acknowledging our sins, so we can celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, who came to heal the contrite,
Lord have mercy.
Christ Jesus, who calls sinners to you, Christ have mercy. And Lord Jesus, who intercede for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who in your wonderful providence decreed that the Christ's kingdom should be extended throughout the earth, and that all should be partakers of the saving redemption. Grant, we pray, that your church may be a universal sacrament of salvation, and that Christ may be revealed to all as the hope of the nations and their Savior. Through this means with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, when Israel was a child, I loved him. Out of Egypt I called my son. The more I called them, the farther they went from me, sacrificing to the Baals and burning incense to idols. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk, who took them in my arms. I drew them with human cords, with bands of love. I fostered them like one who raises an infant to his cheeks. Yet though I stooped to feed my child, they did not know that I was their healer. My heart is overwhelmed, my pity is stirred. I will not give vent to my blazing anger. I will not destroy Ephraim again. For I am God and not man, the Holy One present among you. I will not let the flames consume you. The word of the Lord. Let us see your face, Lord, and we shall be saved.
Let us see your face, Lord, and we shall be saved.
O Shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon the cherubim, shine forth. Rouse your power. Let us hear your face, Lord, and we shall be saved. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect your right hand, what your right hand has planted, the Son of Man whom you yourself made strong. Let us hear your face.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
A reading of the Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory
to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his apostles, as you go, make this proclamation, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, drive out demons. Without cast you have received, and without cost you shall give. And do not take gold or silver or copper for your belts. No sack for the journey, or a second tunic, or sandals, or a walking stick. The laborer deserves his keep. Whatever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person in it, and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, your peace will return to you. Whoever will not accept you or listen to your words, go outside that house or town and shake the dust from your feet. Amen, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When we pray the Our Father often enough, okay, we don't say it, we don't think about the words, I should say. We just say it, and just maybe reflect on it a little bit later on. But in there is thy kingdom come, is what we're praying for. And that's what we hear within the story today, that the kingdom of God is at hand. And so, you know, with that being at hand is how do we contribute to that and make it a reality? About 300 years ago, the Chinese martyrs, they were converted. They went into China. There was about 300 of them. And so what had happened was that each one had a martyr's death. And so, they wanted to go and spread the kingdom of God. They wanted to let them know who the Christ is, that they believed in, and that they wanted to take it to the people and be aware of who the Christ is. And that's what they did. And they met a martyr's death, unfortunately for them. But yet, it was something very glorious for them as well, because they were commissioned to go out and build that kingdom, and let the kingdom be known to the people that they served. So, there was a great reward in their efforts in the end. Okay, they were declared as martyrs, and being shared in the eternal glory with our Lord. But for the kingdom come, okay, that's what we're being challenged to do. And we take from the time of baptism that we have received, okay, to the time, to the present moment, and hereafter, okay, we're trying to make the kingdom of God alive and vibrant within our midst. And often enough, that is what we are striving for. And we ask ourselves, how do we go about doing that? Okay, the use of the talents and the gifts that we have in order to give glorification to God for one, but sharing in the life of the community is one way. For those often enough who would say, we'll pray for you, and taking the time to pray for them is letting them know that what will take place is the prayer, and that that prayer is to be directed towards God and asking God to give them what they need. Sometimes they feel those prayers, and they're very gracious for it. But also, that building of the kingdom of God is there saying, we are looking after you, you have been entrusted to us, and we are going to make it possible to have that union that you're seeking with the God that you believe in your time and affirming. It is going to be a reality, and hopefully, and within faith for us, it takes place. And during this time of the pandemic, what we're doing is we're praying for each other. Okay, we're praying for the sick. We're praying for those who have passed because of it. And also we are praying for the frontline people who are involved and taking care of them. Be the doctors, the nurses, the EMTs, the hospital staffs in different way, and the hospital personnel, but also the ones that we have lived with the individuals as well. They're being taken care of. May they feel the prayers as well. So that's what the kingdom of God is about. Feeling that compassion and that mercy that the Lord showed his people. We go in and do the same. Show them mercy and compassion and understanding that our God has really demonstrated for us is the one way to bring about the kingdom of God. So as we go about our celebration, what does take place is the sacramental side as well. And within that sacramental side, we're seeing another way that we can feel the kingdom is here already with us because of the sacrament that we receive, but it was also instituted by Christ himself. And in that institution, he is letting us know that we are with him and he is with us. We're united together in the constant notion and understanding that we are walking with him, and that walking with him, we continue to build the kingdom of God, which was part of his mission that he extended to all of us. So let us pray and stand and pray for God's people today. So we are praying for the church. Okay, that will be a continuing song of hope for people. During this time, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We are praying for all those who are traveling, that they are kept safe from all. and our loved ones, that hither the Lord will protect and keep us out of harm's way, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are also praying for those who are sick, that they will continue to feel our prayers for one and their caregivers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died, that they be sharing God's eternal presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And so, Lord Jesus, we do stop and we gather our prayers and offer them to you once again. Continue to inspire us, enlighten us, and help us to lead others to the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours is acceptable to God the Father and Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his church. Look upon the offerings of your people consecrated to you, for merciful God, and through the power of this sacrament, grant them that the multitude of those who believe in you may constantly be made a chosen race, royal priesthood, a holy nation, and a people of your own. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to
trust. It is truly right to trust our duty to salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gather them again to yourself, so that people formed by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might through praise your manifold wisdom, by the manifest as the Church. And so, in the company of the angels and saints, we praise you, we form one voice with them as we may. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are holy indeed, O Lord, fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they become for us the body and blood of your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered boldly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection,
giving thanks you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world to bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Frank, our Bishop, and all who serve you. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And so we pray in the words of Jesus as close. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we will be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace, Lord, be with you always.
Amen.
And let us offer a sign of peace. Peace be with you. And Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Amen.
And we make the spiritual communion together. My Jesus, I believe that you are really present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire for you to come into my soul. Though I cannot receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who constantly fed and strengthened the church with your sacraments, grant to us who have been nourished by the heavenly table that by obeying your teachings of love, we may become the human family you desire, a life-giving leaven and the means of salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And the prayer for Father Priest's song. Lord Jesus, who has told us, ask and you shall receive. We address our prayer to you through the intercession of your priest, Louis Priest. Attentive to the signs and the times, and in obedience to your will, he founded the double family of the Oblate Sisters and the Oblates of St. Francis de Sales. Confident in your providence and joyful in hope, he knew as a good father how to make himself all things to all people. Grant us through this intercession the favors which we ask of you, especially. May the Holy Church rejoice in glorifying this priest after your own heart, who gave himself totally to your love. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God continue to bless all of us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Have a great day, everyone.